Why don't we, if you will permit me, why don't we just focus on what we changed?
Yeah, let's just do this.
On the intake, I just added some language that says that to the extent we trigger the 15-year raw water option, that the leasehold extends for 15 years as well. That's all. Going to finished water, to Commissioner Bell's point, the second bullet point, we sort of segregated those two. So the first one required annual minimum purchase of 1.2 billion gallons of water at 225. City, next bullet point, shall make available no less than 6.5 million gallons of water daily based on the 30-day average. So that's been made to be more clear. Golly, I mean, that was really it. I mean, we did put in the additional terms down at the bottom of subparagraph two, that rate adjustment would only be prospective if the Corps of Engineers goes up on its storage costs.
I make a motion that we ask you to draw this up to minimum agreement, and that we send this over to City and County to the Viking for a second. I have discussion. Do you want to do your public hearing thing again?
I have a question, if you may. The original one we typed up, that put down the 30-year leasehold for no less than 65%. And this one we've just written up that you can go back to on twice, it had a 15-year leasehold for no less than 65% intake capacity. Then it gives additional if you do your option.
The leasehold will be the same.
Leasehold the same, so you still have a 30-year leasehold.
Right, but the difference
it's a 15 is, and 15.
Right.
For a total of 30.
Correct.
Thank you.
Is there any further discussion? If not, we have a motion and a second. Please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. Aye. That passes 3-1 with Commissioner Ramos being.
Okay.
So this goes up in June, after June.
You don't like this?
What do you propose to do then? What's your option? Let's send it.
Well, I wanted a cap on the CPIU.
It's in there. Says it's calculated by the city's proposed IGA.
No. By 4%.
Is that not in there, Councilman?
That is a 4% cap.
Yeah.
What is in there?
Yeah, what's in the IGA for the CPIU right now?
As calculated in the city's proposed.
Is that not a 4%
Jody,
cap?
It's okay.
Right. He controls me. I'm going to control him.
Oh, Lord.
The language that I was thinking of is in the city's IGA that I thought there was some discussion that we liked the methodology annually after the commencement date. The fees to be paid shall be increased by the CPI with the numerator being one term, the denominator being the other term. That's what I'm talking about.
Really good. There's not a cap.
Will you agree to it if there's a cap there?
That's what you need. That's why we're having a step.
You're not offering anything. Offer up something. Let's get it done. We cannot go to a June of a hearing.
Reverse and start over again.
Or at least move to have a public hearing this May 15th.
Let's try to knock this out.
Let's get this going. Just needs to tell us what he wants in there and make it really important.
I really like ownership.
I would too, but I don't see that as reality, unfortunately. I don't know how to get that ownership. You can't force him to do it. There's a problem. You asked, what, twice?
Well, he said the reason he couldn't do it is because they have a member-based system, but they don't.
I didn't hear that. I don't know.
I'd like to know who the members are, if there is such a system.
Say again?
He says he's a member-based system.
The mayor said that he has a member-based system, and the mayors did not want the intake sold. But he doesn't have a member-based system, or if he does, I'd like to know who the members are that won't let
you sell. Users
of the system. Well, I'm a user, and nobody ever asked me if I.
Councilor, if a motion is made to move this to the next to the public hearing for May the 15th, is that acceptable?
Okay. Yes.
And then we don't have to wait till June. Because I believe the rule says it be moved to the next public hearing. But if we go ahead and schedule a public hearing on
Yeah, remember, this is what we got into. No, the next public hearing is the June public hearing. And remember, I brought out to you all in the open meeting the notion of changing your rules to make it be any public hearing calendar, and we didn't do that. So right now, your internal rules say that upon a IGA not securing a four, in this case, a unanimous vote of those that can vote, that it goes, a member can make a motion and it goes to the next public hearing calendar, which for us is the June public hearing calendar. And that's the way we've applied it once already. I don't believe I have the discretion to change it.
Because we have to send one, so let's wrap one up.
You were never in favor of countering the offer at all? Because you haven't said anything the whole day.
I wanted ownership.
But you've not said anything as we were sitting here doing
all this. I asked for the 4% and everybody just blew right by it. Everybody else is so busy talking.
Oh gosh, I thought you were running the meeting. Well, how about if we put the 4% in there?
That would be better.
Will it get you to agree, or are we going to go to $1,000?
Can we go to ownership? Why don't we do ownership?
Because it's not on the table.
Who took it off?
The owner of it.
The owner says that it's a membership-based system.
He's elected to represent those members, and until he's not.
He's not elected by me. I don't live in the city.
Well, then you need to talk to city people.
Well, that's what I thought we were
what
doing.
What in the world are you trying to do?
So you just let this contract expire?
You obviously just want to
We're going to let the contract expire?
Yes.
Yeah. I never had a problem with that.
Do you want the citizens of Forsyth County to be subject to $1,000, $1,000 on raw water?
To be subject to anything other than a fair deal.
No, we're not talking about ifs and we're talking about reality. That's reality.
Why is that reality? It's reality that he doesn't have a member-based system.
Okay,
which reality are you talking about?
You just said you're comfortable with the water contract expiring, so you'd be comfortable without a source of water for the citizens of the county?
He turned it off.
No, he's going to charge us $1,000 or $1,000. You're comfortable with that?
Well, we might have to go to court then.
Are you comfortable with that?
But why don't we just try to settle it?
You're comfortable with our job as elected officials to do this? That's what you want us all along. That's what I said earlier. You really don't want to have to make this decision.
Is it because you want the court system to solve this for us?
What's that?
Do you want the court system to solve this for us?
If it gets us a better deal, yeah, it'd be great.
But what if it doesn't get us a better deal?
That's the chance that I'm willing to take.
So you want to settle in the court system?
Or get ownership.
We're not going to get ownership, and I don't think the courts would give us ownership. Do you think the courts would give us ownership, Counselor?
Well, they decree it. It depends what's on the table to the extent that we're paying a capital contribution. But I think if we just go into a courtroom and say we want ownership, I don't think we'll get ownership. But it, you know, to the
extent. What happens if the board doesn't offer us to the board?
Then we will. Well, two things could happen. I mean, depending upon what the bill is for the water, we'll either have to pay it under duress if we believe it's too high, or escrow it. And you might have to, you know, to the extent that you believe that the board collectively decides that the bill is too high and that we don't believe the rates are justifiable, you may want me to file a declaratory judgment action or some sort of an action.
But if you don't get
the instruction from the board to commence that?
It's at a 2-2, what happens? This is our meeting topic.
Who are you asking? Because
Well, if the board doesn't take the position that it wants to fight the rate structure, then we would simply have to pay it.
And what if you don't pay it? And what if you do it under duress? And what if you don't pay it?
Well, you're not going to do it. If you're not going to challenge it, doing it under duress makes little sense. I mean, to be candid, makes little sense. So we would simply pay it until such time as there is a
board that challenges it. Because you're not going to ever come up with an agreement with the board, it sounds like. How do you get an agreement?
So let me ask you a question. We have a 3-1 vote right now. Does a 3-1 vote send it across the street?
Not as a binding offer.
Okay.
That can be accepted. It's not.
Not yet, anyways.
But it can send it across the street. It's a public record. Any of us can take it across the
yes,
street.
Yes, it can be sent over as a non-binding offer, as we did before. I just got a chilling
reception. Which got rejected because it wasn't binding.
Correct.
So you're willing to put all this at risk?
All this because of ownership of something?
Well, I wish you'd have told us this yesterday. We didn't need to have this meeting.
What a waste
of time.
Well,
we did. We did in order to get to this point, didn't we?
No, you could have just made the announcement.
I'm not going to vote for it.
But I wouldn't have had the benefit of hearing all these arguments. Now I have.
And your point is?
I've arrived at the same place.
So you wasted staff time.
I didn't waste anything.
We've got an attorney sitting down here that's on contract. You've wasted my time that I've been a business to run. You have wasted my time.
You wasted your time. I didn't ask you to run a business.
You're retired.
I didn't ask you to run a business. That was your choice.
Why don't you come up to a grown-up level instead of the elementary?
Well, I think this is a disservice.
It absolutely is.
Ready to sit here for 2 days and tell the board I was never going to vote on in the first place.
I didn't say I never was going to vote on it. I said I wanted ownership.
But why did you say that yesterday?
I think he's always been on that stance.
But why didn't he say something?
I don't know.
What a waste of time.
I just said this morning at 8:00 when we started.
Well, then consider it a waste of time. What do you want to do now?
I'm going to sit here until we find out what your offer is. I want you to draft an offer, tell the counselor what you want, and let's.
I liked the previous offer. What was wrong with it?
It was not accepted, Jim.
Okay, we'll send it back. Why can't we send it back over?
What world do you live in, Jim? What world are you living in?
Ours.
It's the world I live in. I was elected, and this is how I'm representing the people that elected me.
My letter to water contract expired.
Litigation.
Litigation.
Dollar a thousand. Except.
You're the one who don't want to go into litigation. You're the one who, if we.
It's not.
You're the ones who, if it comes to that, are making noises like, okay, we won't fund any kind of a law. We'll just pay the extra water rate.
I think that it would be that in order to serve the citizens of the county, you should make a proposal.
Right now.
You should make a proposal that you
believe is fair. Let's hear it.
He just said
he wants ownership.
We all agreed yesterday that a totally reasonable proposal was the one we sent across there. In fact, you said it was superb yesterday.
Excellent. Yep. It was wonderful.
Excellent.
But it was rejected.
We'll send it again. Maybe they'll change their mind.
What world are you living in?
So that's your position, send the previous proposal back over?
Yeah, why not?
All right. I would rather.
That's negotiation at its best.
Yeah. I think it would be more.
Actually, I've seen it done. I've seen it accepted.
Fair.
I've seen him lowered and seen him accepted.
To tell us what you want as an offer, you want ownership. What does ownership entail? Do we get water out of it? How much do we pay for it? What are the terms of the agreement?
I like the previous agreement.
Well, Jim, that one's not on the table. It's just not.
Well, then what world do you
Well, maybe he can bring it up.
You ask me to do something, I do it, and then you say it's not possible.
It's been rejected, Jim.
They might accept it this time.
And you're right, they might. So you're making a motion to send it back over again?
Yeah. I'll make a motion to resend the previous proposal.
Which previous proposal? Make it a little clearer so we know which one.
The previous binding proposal?
The April 26th proposal that was entered yesterday in the
agenda book. Is that what your proposal is?
Yes.
I'll second that. Give four votes.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign.
Aye.
Aye. All right, we voted. Now, we voted, though, 3-1 to send this proposal. It's non-binding.
Yes.
Okay. All right, well, how about this? How about if we extend the existing contract?
To win. Yeah,
of course. Let's not make that. What's wrong? I would like to make a motion that this board consider a formal censure of Commissioner Boff for shirking his responsibilities to the citizens of the county. If not, I'll follow that. Because we've heard it all along that he wants us to go to litigation, so he doesn't have to make a decision. It's an election year. He doesn't want to have to listen to those people out there that he thinks are upset with the city. And it's a total disregard to the benefit of the citizens for instead of act like an elementary school child.
Well, can I ask one thing before we storm out? Just before we storm out, chill for a second. If you tell me if this here, the one that we just voted 3-1 on, if under the intake it asked for ownership instead of that, and you had a cap of 4%.
Go to June.
That you would vote for this today.
In fact, I'd be willing to drop the 4% if it had the ownership.
So let's add it in there. We've added it in there, but that's a request. We'll count it.
So be it. And we get four votes today.
Yeah, we'll send it over.
No, yes, maybe. I mean...
I think we've, you know, I think Commissioner Boff has decided the direction he wants to go, and we voted 3-1 to send this proposal over here. This is a proposal that the board is behind, and, you know, when it goes over June 7th, maybe the city will be willing to keep things status quo for 2 or 3 weeks by until we can vote on June 7th.
Do we want to make a motion to send over non-binding?
Well, hold on a second. Yeah. It sounds like if you change this like to ownership.
You know what?
Yeah, but that's already been rejected.
I have wasted enough time with him, my time and all these people's time to come in here.
I mean, this is a disservice. Like
it is a disservice. It's a disservice to our staff, our citizens, and it's a total disrespect of your time, my time, and his time.
Motion to adjourn.
And his time. I'd like to ask you to withdraw that. I'd like to make a motion that we send this over as a non-binding.
Second.
Okay, just...
I withdrew my motion to adjourn.
Thank you.
I'd like to make a motion that we send this over as a non-binding agreement to request input from the city.
Second.
Oh, Lord.
You voted to approve it. Certainly, you voted for which they're going to say it's not binding. Why'd you send it over here?
I know. You're right.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. That passes 4-0.
Is the board's expectation that this be distilled into an IGA we sent over, or just
I don't
the bullet,
think we want to put any more
just the bullet point
cost into
one?
It.
I think we've wasted enough time.
Is that
Wasted enough time.
Commissioner Levent, is that your?
I'm fine.
Okay, then I'll just basically take what I've got here and put a cover letter for Mr. Dean.
Can you get it over by email to him today?
I will have it to them today. I will have it to them today.
I'm going to make a motion that we request that the city of Cumming leave the current raw and finished water contracts in place until June 8th.
Until we can get a legitimate answer, is that what you're asking?
Yeah, we'll get this until we can vote on it June 7th.
I think that we need to allow Chairman Boff to have his way.
Let's not do that, because that's kind of... Don't let your emotions get involved.
It's not emotions. He's...
They might say no. They might say what you're trying to say right now. It's not a done deal. But at least we're, you know, this is looking out for the best interest of the citizens.
I have no problem
asking them to hold off until we can get through
the bureaucracy of that.
I'll second your motion.
Well, then you have it. Sounds like it's going to fly if they accept it.
Do we need to go through June?
Let's say June 15th.
That's fair enough. Yeah. Did you second June 15th?
Hold on. Okay, let me redo my motion.
Thank you.
All right, so I'm just trying to look at the calendar real quick on when their next meeting would be. They have a meeting on the 15th or the 22nd. Do you know, City? 15th?
Whatever.
Third
Tuesday.
Third Tuesday is the 15th.
Will you withdraw your second first?
Yeah, I did. I'm sorry. Okay. So then their next meeting would be the 19th of June. So, and if we vote on it on the 7th, maybe they'd call a meeting, maybe they wouldn't, who knows. So let's ask if they keep the current contract in place till June the 20th.
Second motion.
That's your motion?
Yeah.
Second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. I believe that passes 4-0 with Commissioner Annis.
Then what I'm going to do is when we draft the letter to Mr. Blackburn, we will simply put this in there that we're making a formal request that the existing IGAs be extended to June 20th, and then also contain these bullet points as an attachment to that letter.
Yes, I
agree. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye. All those opposed, like signs. Was that unanimous, Pete?
I hope I didn't push it off.
Yes.
You voted aye.
Thank you guys for all your
votes.